Hello, my dear children. Children, in the class today, we'll study magnetic properties of substances. Well, on the basis of behavior of a substance in magnetic field, you know that when a substance is placed in magnetic field, it starts behaving like a magnet. It also acquires magnetic properties. So, on the basis of behavior of a substance in magnetic field, all substances have been classified into three categories, and these three categories are, so these substances are diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic, and we will study these three type of substances on comparative basis. We compare their behavior in magnetic field. So how these substances are different from each other and how are they similar? Well, these are the heads under which we are going to discuss them. These heads are induced magnetic induction, net magnetic field, relative permeability, magnetic susceptibility, and finally temperature dependence of magnetic susceptibility. So, what are diamagnetic substances? These substances are very feebly magnetically induced in the direction opposite of external magnetic field. When we place these substances, diamagnetic substances, in external magnetic field, what happens? The magnetic field which is induced in the substance is very very weak and it is in the direction opposite of the external field. This is external field towards right, this is diamagnetic substance, and the induced field is just opposite of the external field. But remember, this induced field is very very small. The substances are very feebly magnetically induced in the direction opposite of the external magnetic field. This is natural behavior of a substance. But if we look at paramagnetic substances, these substances are very feebly magnetically induced in the direction parallel to external magnetic field. The only difference between this and this is, well, here the induced magnetic field is weak and opposite, but here the induced field is very weak, like here, but unlike here, the field is parallel to external field. So this is substance placed in magnetic field B0. Induced field is in the same direction as external field, but it is what? Parallel. Here it is antiparallel, but here it is parallel. This B dash is, as usual, very very small, as the magnetic induction is very very feeble. So B dash is much more smaller than B0. Here also B dash is much more smaller than B0. Here it is antiparallel and here it is parallel. Ferromagnetic substance. Ferromagnetic substances are very strongly, these two are very feebly magnetically induced, but these substances are very strongly magnetically induced in the direction parallel to external field. So these two substances are similar in term of the direction of induced field, but the induced field here is very very weak and here it is very very strong, very very huge. Induced field is very very large, and that too parallel to the external field. So paramagnetic and ferromagnetic substances, they show unnatural behavior. Normally induced field in electric field, as you have seen, is produced in the opposite direction. That is natural behavior. But in magnetism, only here the induced field is in the direction opposite of the external field, but for these two substances the induced field is in the same direction as is that of the external field. Well, how do we apply this B0? This B0 is applied with the help of solenoid. And what do we do? We place the substance inside the current carrying solenoid. And as you place the substance is inside the core of a solenoid. And as the current passes through the solenoid, the magnetic field B0 acts over the substances in all three situations. And you know this B0. This B0 is nothing but mu0 times H. We have already discussed last time. It is mu0 times H. We have already discussed this in the last lecture. Now, the next head is magnetic induction. magnetic induction means net magnetic field in the substance. Now, what is magnetic field in the substance when induced field in the direction opposite of the external field? See, the net magnetic field in the substance is going to be vector sum of these two fields. Since both the fields are in opposite direction, B naught towards right, B dash towards left, therefore net field here is going to be sum of these two antipodal vector, and that is going to be what? B naught minus B dash. Why minus? Simply because B dash is opposite of B naught. Well, here the net field is going to be B naught plus B dash. Why? Because B dash is parallel to B naught. Therefore, net field is going to be vector sum of these two parallel vectors, and that vector sum is simple sum. Same way here also, since B dash and B naught, they are parallel to each other. Therefore, net field inside is what? B naught plus B dash. This B is very slightly less than B naught. This B dash is very, very small. Therefore, net field is very slightly less than B naught. And this, in this case, as usual, B dash is much more smaller than B naught. Therefore, B is very slightly more than B naught. And here, B dash is much more greater than B naught. Therefore, net field, this is much more greater than this. Therefore, net field is much more greater than the field without substance, that is field in the free space. Relative permeability. Well, relative permeability, we know, is nothing but the ratio of net magnetic field in the substance to magnetic field without substance. In the last lecture, we have already seen that this B naught is what? Mu naught times magnetizing field. And what is this B? Mu times H. And you can see that if we divide B naught from B, B naught upon B, what happens? This H cancels out. And what are we left with? Mu upon mu naught. So this is nothing but, if we divide B, that is mu H, with B naught, mu naught H. What do we get? Mu upon mu naught. And what is that? That is what is relative permeability. So relative permeability is the ratio of magnetic induction in the medium to magnetic induction without medium, that is magnetic induction in the free space. Magnetic induction is another name for magnetic field. So what is relative permeability of diamagnetic substances? Mu R. Yeah, see, B upon B naught is mu R. So if we change the side of B naught, this side, what do we get? Mu R. And what is that mu R? That mu R is going to be less than 1. Here, relative permeability is B upon B naught. If we change the side of B naught, this side, if we bring this B naught, this side, what are we left with here? 1. And what is this ratio for as relative permeability? The relative permeability is slightly more than 1. And here again, B upon B naught is what? Much more greater than 1. So for diamagnetic substances, relative permeability is slightly less than 1. For para, slightly more than 1, but for ferro, it is much more greater than 1. Mu R is very slightly less than 1. How much slightly less than 1? Let us see the example. Bismuth. Relative permeability of bismuth is 0.999834. Slightly less than. Well, it is very slightly more than 1. So, what? How much slightly more than 1? Let us see it with the above example. Aluminium is a paramagnetic substance. Its relative permeability is 1.00023. And iron, which is a ferromagnetic substance, relative permeability is 5000, much more greater than 1. Children, next here is magnetic susceptibility. What is magnetic susceptibility? We have already studied. So, diamagnetic substance have negative and very small magnetic susceptibility. Why negative and very small? It is simply because, well, magnetic susceptibility is relative permeability minus 1. For diamagnetic substance, we have just seen that mu R is slightly less than 1. If we subtract 1 from slightly less than 1, what are we going to get? Negative. So for diamagnetic substance, magnetic susceptibility is negative and it is very small. We have just seen the value of mu R for bismuth, and if we subtract from that mu R 1, we get minus 0.000166. For paramagnetic substance, well, mu R minus 1 is going to be slightly more than 1. It is positive and very small. So the magnetic susceptibility of paramagnetic substance is positive and very small.
If we subtract one from the relative probability here, aluminium 1.0023. If from here we subtract one, what do we get? Kyle for iron A, sorry, aluminium is 0.00023. For probability substance, it is positive and very high. Well, we know that relative probability is 5000 for iron. If we subtract one, it becomes 4999. That is very, very high still, positive and very high. And the last point is temperature dependence of magnetic susceptibility. So diamagnetic substances are those substances where magnetic susceptibility does not depend upon temperature. It is of course negative, it is of course very small, but at the same time it doesn't depend upon temperature. Therefore, if you plot a graph between chi and temperature, the value is negative, this is the negative value, and that negative value remains same irrespective of the value of temperature. And the examples of the materials, diamagnetic materials, are what? Bismuth, copper, diamond, gold, lead, mercury, silicon, and so on. These are some of the examples of diamagnetic substances. Well, for paramagnetic substances, chi is inversely proportional to temperature. Magnetic susceptibility for paramagnetic substances is inversely proportional to temperature. And this is what is called as Curie law. So what is Curie's law? According to Curie's law, magnetic susceptibility of paramagnetic substances is inversely proportional to temperature. Very, very important. And if you remove sign of proportionality, we get a constant. What is that constant? That constant is Curie's constant. If you plot chi versus T graph, we get a rectangular hyperbola. As the temperature increases, the value of magnetic susceptibility decreases with the rise of temperature. The examples of paramagnetic substances besides aluminium are what? Calcium, chromium, lithium, magnesium, oxygen, platinum, tungsten is also a paramagnetic substance, and so on. There are a number of examples. And if we look at paramagnetic substances, chi, that is magnetic susceptibility, depends upon temperature in a complicated way. What is that complicated variation? That complicated variation shows direct as well as inverse variation, both. This is chi versus temperature graph for iron, and the graph is like this. As the temperature rises, the value of chi initially increases and then it decreases. The temperature at which the value of chi becomes maximum is called Curie's temperature. Very, very important. So Curie's temperature is the temperature at which ferromagnetic substance has maximum value of magnetic susceptibility. Well, we can also define this Curie's temperature, the temperature beyond which the substance starts behaving like paramagnetic substance. See, in this part, chi is directly proportional to temperature, but in this part, the chi is inversely proportional to temperature. That means the temperature beyond which the substance magnetic susceptibility decreases with the rise of temperature. This is paramagnetic behavior. This is ferromagnetic behavior. The temperature beyond which a ferromagnetic substance starts showing paramagnetic behavior is also called Curie's temperature. And the examples of the substances which show this behavior, ferromagnetic substances, are, besides iron, they are what? Copper, nickel, or steel, soft iron, or alloy made up of these metals. So, students, we come to the end of today's class. Thank you very much, and God bless you all.